And for those who can't see it, it says 1/2 y plus 1/3 equals 1/4. And I'll write it on the board. 1/2 y plus 1/3 equals 1/4. One half y plus 1/3 is equal to 1/4. One half y plus 1/3 is equal to 1/4. So to make life easier on us, what is the common denominator of 2, 3, and 4? What's the common denominator? Are y'all going to answer me, or are y'all just not going to say anything?
To do it.
Huh? Oh, you're trying to do it? Okay, I'll shut up. 2, 3, 4. 2, 1, 3, 2. 3, 1, 1, 2. 2, 1, 1, 1. So 3 times 4 is what? 3 times 4 is what? That's what I heard.
12,
thank you. I didn't hear 12. All I heard was man. So I'm going to multiply by 12 over 1. And what happens to our fractions, basically? Where does this one go to? 6y, Hubert. Thank you, class. What does this one go to?
4.
And this one?
3.
And now you're ready to solve it. 6y is equal to what?
-1.
And y is equal to -1/6. So whenever possible, clear the fractions, because it makes life a whole lot easier on yourself. Hold on a second and I'll rewind it. I was going to give you another one. Let's go ahead and do number 50. R over 3 plus 2R is equal to 7. R over 3 plus 2R is equal to 7. R over 3 plus 2R is equal to 7. There you go. There's the one we just finished. R over 3 plus 2R is equal to 7. Clear the fraction. So multiply through by what? Multiply through by what? Multiply through by the common denominator, Hubert. Yeah, that's right. And what is the common denominator? 3, Hubert, that's right. So multiply through by 3 over 1. three over one, three over one, three over one. and multiply through r over 3 plus 2r over 1 is equal to 7 over 1. And what happens to the 3s? And that leaves you with r plus 3 times 2 is 6r equals what? And 7r is equal to 21. R is equal to what? 3. All right. Let's try a nerd. All right, try that one. And that is a test question. Not the same exact, but that's the kind you'll have on the test. Common denominator of 3 and 2.
Oh, I started with the first half. I was going to do the second.
You got to go all the way through. What am I going to multiply by? What's the common denominator? 6. Multiply by 6 over 1. How many terms are you going to multiply by 6 over 1? How many? Well, yeah, that's a good answer, all of them, but how many is that?
6.
How many?
8. 4. Where's the 4?
1, 2, 3, 4.
I would say you don't do the
Can you get ring out of a concrete block?
No.
Nope. You gotta bust it up. Now, I see about three or four of y'all using your phones. Now, one, I hope you're texting somebody because you shouldn't need a calculator for this. And two, if you are texting somebody, then you're just being what?
Rude.
Rude, because what would you do if you came up to me and asked me a question and I started texting while you were asking me a question? What would y'all do? What would y'all say that I was being if you were asking me a question and y'all were playing on Facebook while I was playing on Facebook while you were asking me a question? What would you say?
Do you really?
Bull crap!
Do you really?
You would say that I was being rude. That's what you would say.
I wouldn't say
that. Oh, no. You would just sit here and say, Mr. McClure, I need you to answer this question, and I sit there and play on Facebook. What would you say?
I'd say we first get on the phone and answer my question.
I just grown up
question. I just told you what I'd say. I just told you what I'd say.
Y'all would all say he's being rude, but it's okay for y'all to do it to me.
No.
All right. What happens to the 6/3? I'm going to ask you again,
yes,
what is 6/3?
It turns into a 2.
2. And this turns to a 2, and 2 times 2 is 4. And 6 divided by 2 is? And 6 times 6 is? Now you don't have any fractions. And now you just distribute and combine like terms and solve. I'm going to give you a few minutes to finish that one. Distribute the 2, 3, and then combine like terms. What does this one become?
2x plus 6 minus 4.
2x plus 6 minus 4.
Not 5.
Yeah. Minus 4 is equal to, what does this one become?
3x minus 15. What are you doing?
I don't know. I'm just writing different numbers. 3x minus 15 plus... bureaucrats. Plus 36. Now, whenever I told you before, whenever you use the distributive law, what usually falls after the distributive law? Combining like what? That usually comes next. So what is 6 minus 4? 2x
plus 6 minus 4.
Two, Hubert. That's right, class. And what's negative 15 plus 36? 15 plus 6 is 21. Somebody help me out. Now, I'm going to bring the 2x over because I like to keep my variable positive. So that's going to leave us with x. And then bring the negative 21 over, and 2 minus 21 is negative what? Negative 19. So your answer should be negative 19.
Just so I have this straight, you have 2x, you brought it over and did what with it? I'm sorry, you don't...
3x minus 2x, I brought it over here and it became a minus 2x.
Why can't you just write that?
Sorry.
Damn.
I'm sorry.
You should be. If you want me to take accurate notes.
Maybe I should just go play on Facebook.
We don't have to have a sensor for your video.
Say again?
We don't have to have a sensor for your video.
A sensor?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What'd I say?
You're going to have to be quiet.
What'd I say?
Yeah, somebody's going to fuss about my videos because somebody in the last class did that too. So y'all going to have to watch it. Thank you. I didn't even think about that.
I don't usually watch my own.
I know, it's just with me, right?
I only do it when customers are around.
Okay, just me?
No, it's just my everyday life. I'm in the airport.
Well, you know, just...
I know, I'm... really bad.
Somebody will complain, and they won't fuss at you. They'll fuss at me. So you can do it if you want to get people to fuss at me. You can do it. That's fine.
No, I like you too much.
Fuss at me. I don't care.
All right, let's do it nerd. How about this one? There you go. This is one of those that if you do distribute the fractions, you just get more what? More fractions, more work. Say again? I'm sorry.
Could you turn both of the improper fraction on the inside, which after you distribute?
No, they're just going to be fractions. Just fractions and more fractions. The first, best thing to do is multiply 3 by the common denominator, which would be 2 times 3 times 5, which would be what, 30?
30, yeah.
So go ahead and multiply through by 30. How many terms are you going to multiply by 30?
3.
3. Good. I'm proud of you.
Since this is an equation that equals an equation to see if it, they equal the same number, couldn't you just solve the first equation and then solve the second equation and then...
No, they equal each other.
I understand that. So would the answer be the same if you just solve for one of them?
Well, you don't know what they equal. They equal each other. You don't have a number that they equal. You can't say 1 is equal to 6. I mean, you can't do that. You can't say... I mean, what are you going to equal 1 half times x minus 5? What are you going to equal it to?
You're going to have to solve for it.
Solve for what? You don't have a number.
You don't...
You got to have a number to solve for. See, this side is equal to this side.
Yeah, you're so thinking, they both have the same answer.
Okay, so let's take
the
left side.
To have the same
1/2 times x minus 5 equal to what number?
I don't know, x.
You can't do that. You can't just pull out a number and set this
well,
equal
no,
to that.
You have to solve for it and then get the answer, right?
You have to have a number over here to solve it. I'm glad you're using your brain. You're thinking.
Well, I don't not think in my life.
Well, no. What I'm saying is I'm glad you're thinking about solving, but the problem is you can't do that because you don't have a number to solve for. So I'm going to multiply through by the common denominator, which is 30 over 1. Ooh. 30 over 1, 30 over 1, 30 over 1, 1/2 times x minus 5, equals 1/3 plus 1/5 times x plus 2. Now, what happens with the 2 and the 30?
Multiply.
15.
Cancel and you get 15.
Wait, so you have to divide?
Yeah, 30 divided by 2 or multiply by 1/2, whichever. 30 divided by 2, or 30 times 1/2, is 15. Times x minus 5 is equal to, excuse me, how many times will 3 go into 30? 10 times 1 is 10. And 5 will go into 30 6 times. Okay, now what?
Distribute.
Fifteen times 5 is 75. Mm-hmm. Thought it was 15. And that's equal to 10 plus 6x plus 12. And usually when you use distributive law, what comes next? Combining like terms. There's nothing over here to combine. But over here, the 10 and the 12 will give you what? 22. Now, I like to keep my variable positive, so I'm going to bring the 6x over. And the 75 comes over. And what's 15 minus 6?
Oops.
9, Hubert. And what's 22 plus 75? 97. and x is equal to 97 ninths. That's your answer. So you can do these things all day long.
Unless you have a life.
Yeah, unless you have a life, yeah. All right, well, what if you're given, you got fractions down, but what if you're given decimals? Let's take a look at this one right here, 45. I'll blow it up for you. 45 says 0.9x minus 1.2 is equal to 2.4. Now, there's two ways to do this problem. One is to leave it like it is and depend on the calculator. Mm-hmm. The other way is to clear the decimals and do it with whole numbers. The way that you do that is whatever decimal place is held up, that's what you multiply by, the furthest. Ten. So, in this case, you have a tenth, a tenth, and a tenth. Then you would multiply through by 10. And that's how you do it. So, 0.9 minus 1.2 is equal to 2.4. 0.9 minus 1.2. Whoa. 0.9x plus what?
Minus
what?
1.2.
Is equal to 1.4.
2.4.
2.4. I have no short-term memory at all.
Okay. It goes with old age.
Yeah, I know. But the problem is mine's never been there. All right. So I'm going to multiply through by 10. Now, you still don't need a calculator because you know and when you multiply by tens, hundreds, and thousands, you count the number of zeros and you move the decimal to the right that many places. So in this case, how many zeros have I got? So you move it one place to the right, and that gives you 9x minus 12 is equal to 24. Now I would much rather deal with this than having to deal with this, because therefore you depend on the calculator. It's kind of like if you work forever on a cash register, you forget how to make change.
This is true.
And that's why you can't use the calculator all the time, because then you forget how to think. So, take the 12 over, and you get 9x is equal to 36, and x is equal to what?
4.
Bet it ain't broke. How many times do I gotta say if it ain't broke, don't fix it?
At least 500,000 more.
The way I think and do mine.
How did you do yours?
Another way.
How did you do yours?
I just put my decimal when I get ready to divide.
What do you mean divide?
When you divide 36 by 9, I just leave everything.
You work with decimals through the problem.
Yeah.
What did I say when I began this problem?
I didn't get it out.
Say it, I'll say it one more time.
I was working on the problem.
Yeah, you don't listen to the thing I say.
I was already working on the problem.
I said there's two ways to work this problem. One is to work with the decimals, and then you have to rely on a calculator.
I didn't use a calculator.
I'm not saying you did. You know, a lot would help you if you would listen.
I can't help it no more. I just don't.
Oh, Lord. Okay, I'm going to do the next problem.
The next problem is 46. 5x plus 0.050 is equal to negative 0.732. I'll blow that one up for you. Now this one, you have it multiplied by what? You got tens, hundreds, thousands. So you're going to multiply everything by 1,000. And when you do that, it'll make all whole numbers. Make it a whole lot easier to work with. Five X plus 0.50. You're gonna have to read it back to me. 5x plus 0.050 is equal to what?
0.732.
Which one?
Oh,
this one?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm going to multiply by, all the way through, by 1,000. Now, I think most of y'all know what 5 times 1,000 is.
Yeah, if you don't.
You need to use a calculator.
No, you need to leave the place.
Plus, what happens here? Move it. That's 50. Is equal to negative what? 732. Now, I would much rather deal with this than having to deal with this. And that's going to be 5,000x is equal to negative 782. 5,000x, oh, I'm sorry, x.
Wait, don't
is you... equal to negative 782 divided by 5,000, and then you reduce. And I think you can reduce down by an even number because of the 2 and the 0. So I'm just going to divide by 2. X is equal to 2 would be what? 2 would be 386. I'm thinking out loud. Let's just do it by hand. That'd be negative, and 2 will go in here 3 times. That'll leave 18. 2 will go in there 9 times, and 1. Y'all check me on that.
Yeah.
And then, of course, I don't have to think here. That's 2,500. And I don't think 391, that's not going to be easy to divide into, especially 7 maybe. I don't know if 7 will go into it. 7 will go into 39. 5 times, leave 41. No, I think that's going to be it. And that's your answer. All right, let's try Nerdy. Huh?
Oh, I thought somebody had a question.
All right, let's try another. 0.3 times x minus 1/3 or 1/5 is equal to 0.5 times x minus 1/3 plus 0.6. Try that.
You start with the decimal or the fractions first?
No, you start with the decimal.
You're trying to figure out.
Clear the decimals first because you can't touch the fractions.
Okay.
because of the concrete block.
Shit. Mm-hmm.
What am I going to multiply through by?
10.
Multiply through by 10, and that's going to give you 3 times x minus 1/5 equals 5 times x minus 1/3 plus 6. Now, you need to go through and distribute, and then you're going to clear the fraction. Because if you try to distribute the 0.3 and the 0.5 and the 0.6, or the 0.5 and the 0.3, you're going to end up with a mess. Unless any of you ever taken 30% of 1/5. That is a messy number.
How do you distribute a whole number? Fraction,
that's
the
exactly
still there.
What I would like to have.
Well, y'all, what did I tell y'all? Whenever you end out, make it a fraction.
Oh, duh.
I don't feel like going back to my notes.
Yeah. Now, I want you to clear the fraction. And yes, this is a test question.
Thanks for warning me.
You're welcome. That is exactly what you're supposed to do. You multiply, you cleared the decimal by multiplying 3 by 10. And then you distributed the 3 and the 5, which gave you more fractions. That would be 3x minus 3/5.
I just found the common denominator.
You can't.
Okay.
You can't do that unless you multiply through everything by the common denominator. Have to multiply through all the
Okay.
Yeah.
So if we found a common denominator, we have to multiply through
everything.
Okay.
That's how you clear it.
Okay.
Everything. So you got to multiply through, and we'll do it in pink. I'm going to multiply through by 15 over 1. So, 15 over 1. And yes, you could combine these two if you wanted to, but it'd be a mess. So that's why I'm just saying clear it. That'd be 3x over 1 minus 3 over 15. Oops, sorry, 3 over 5. Is equal to 5x over 1 minus 5/3 plus 6 over 1. I mean, I didn't do anything. I just brought everything down.
I know, but I don't know if I copied it right, or I'm just feel like I'm losing something. Whoa.
I'm moving it. Hold on. What's 15 times 3? Well, you don't have to. 15 times 3 is 45. 45x. What happens to the 5 and the 15? Makes a 3, Hubert. And what's 3 times 3? Fifteen times 5 is 75. What's 5 times 5?
45.
And 15 times 6 is 90. And now you can combine like terms and get it a little bit, clean it up a little bit. 45x. Minus 9 is equal to 75x plus, well, let me ask you a question. What's negative 25 plus 100? 75, right? Right? Negative 25 plus 100, that's 75. Well, what would be negative 25 plus 90? Be 10 less than 75, which would be what? 65. Now, I don't want my x to be negative, so I'm going to bring this 45 over here. And that'll give me 30x. And I'm going to bring this 65 over here. And what's negative 9 minus 65? Negative 70 what? Negative 74, Hubert. That's right, class. And then divide by 30. And that's your answer, and we can reduce that. 37 over 15. And that's your final answer, negative 37 over 15. So this question right here is a question not only with decimals in it, but what?
Fractions.
Fractions and decimals.
It looks very complicated to begin with, but kind of once you get about halfway through it, it gets a little confusing.
Yeah, it does, because that's the whole point of doing it. The whole point of doing all this is to get it to a Algebra 1 problem right here, taking a big problem and whittling it down to the basic. That's what you're doing. This is what you're shooting for right here. Because once you get it to here, anybody in a Math 155 class can work this problem out because it's Algebra 1. Like I said, a good portion of your test is going to come from 6.2 or whatever section is here.
Can we do another one with decimals and fractions?
Huh?
Can we do another one with decimals and fractions?
Yeah, be glad to. Let me make one up. Let's go with... One half times x minus 0.1 or 0.20 plus 3/5 is equal to 1/4 times x plus 0.4 or 0.40. There you go. What's the common denominator here?
Twenty.
So multiply through by 20 over 1. 20 over 1. 20 over 1. 20 over 1. 1 half times x minus 0.2 plus 3 fifths equals 1 fourth times x plus 0.4. And that becomes a 5. That becomes a 4. That becomes a 10. 10 times 1 is 10. Plus 4 times 3 is 12. 5 times 1 is 5. 10. Now this one clears, but that ain't gonna do anything over there because that's gonna make another decimal over there. But this one, unfortunately or coincidentally, it clears. 10x is 10x, sorry. And 10 times 0.2 is what? 2. Plus 12 is equal to 5x plus, what's 5 times 0.4? 0.2. So we still have a decimal. So I'm going to go ahead and combine these two because they're whole numbers and I can do that. And it's just easy math. So 10x, what's negative 2 plus 12? Plus 10, Hubert. Thank you, class. Equals 5x plus 0.2. Now, what am I going to multiply through by?
10.
10. So go ahead and do that while I take it to the next board.
You're multiplying everything.
Everything. You can't just multiply pieces. You multiply the whole thing.
Unless it's in parentheses.
Yeah. Through by 10. And when you do that, you're going to get 100x plus 100 is equal to what? 50x plus what? Well, 10, move the decimal what? Be what?
2.
2. And 50 comes over, makes 50x. That negative 100 comes over, and that makes it what? 2 minus 100 is negative what? Divide by 50. And x is equal to, well, we can divide half of 100 is 50. So half of this would be 49. So that'd be negative 49 over 25. And that's your final answer.
Wow. That one was easier than.
Yeah, well, that's what I thought you were going to do one like. Then we'll do another one. All right, we'll do another one. Let me go back. Is that the one y'all talking about? One like that one? Okay. Sorry. Let me find it. There it is. All right. Let's take this one. And we will move it over and change it around a little bit. Change this guy and this guy to a 4. Oops. To a 4 and an 8. And we will change Yeah.
Okay. So the decimals, well, two of them are by the hundreds,
mm-hmm.
and one of them is by the tens. Can we add a zero?
No.
Does that change it?
You know what you do is you multiply by the furthest. So which one is further, 100 or 10?
100.
100. So you're going to multiply through by 100. You multiply everything by 100, which is three things.
So 0.20 and 0.2 are two different numbers?
Mm-hmm. No, that doesn't help you.
It doesn't help you by
this. Okay. Multiply through by 100, and that's going to move the decimal two places on each one of them.
So
it's going to add a zero to that last one, which you're talking about doing, and make it 20.
Oh, so that's why you wouldn't add the zero before you start. That's exactly what I mentally did.
Don't do that.
So you have to look at the number that it goes
through.
Okay.
What decimal is the furthest? And 100 is further than 10. So you multiply it through by 100. Because if you multiply it by 10, it would still give you decimals. Because the 0.01, it would be 0.1, and the 0.05 would be 5.5. So you still have decimals. So you got to multiply by something that'll make whole numbers out of everything.
So you just kind of add a step
and you would multiply. Yeah, you would add another step in. Yeah, you multiply by 10, okay. And then you have to multiply by another 10 to get it to move over.
I'm hungry. What are you confused about? Well, it's a tenth, and the other two are hundredths. So if you have a mixture, you go with the furthest. Which one's further, a hundredth or a tenth? So you multiply all the way through by a hundred. And when you do that, that moves in decimal places two places. So I'm going to multiply through by 100. So that's going to move this one two places. So that'd be a one.
Yes.
So that's one.
And that two would be a 20, right?
There you go. Good. Times x minus 1/4 equals 1/2 times x minus 1/8 plus 1/2, and that would be a 20. Now, like I said, you could have multiplied by 10 and got rid of the 0.2, but you would have had a 0.1 here and a 0.5 here, and then multiply by 10 again, you'd get 20, and then you'd get 5 and get 1. So you could do it by 10s twice, or you could do it by 100 once.
This is
kind of
where I'm stuck at. Would you
distribute? Mm-hmm.
So it'd be like.
So it'd be 1 over 1 and 5 over 1. There you go. So 1 times x is 1x minus 1/4 is equal to 5x minus 5 over what? 8 plus 20. And now you need to go through and multiply by what?
Multiply.
Well, you got to get a common denominator. Multiply by the common denominator to clear the fraction. Huh?
Is it 8 over 1?
Yeah, 8 is the common denominator. Mm-hmm. So multiply through by 8 over 1. And that's going to give you 8x minus, what's 8 divided by 4? 2. 8 times 5 is 40. 8's cancel, you get 5. And 8 times 20 is 160. 8x minus 2 is equal to 40x. Minus 5 plus 160 is 155. And we'll copy that and go to the next page. My variable positive, so I'm going to bring the 8x over. Negative 2 is equal to 32x minus plus 155. Negative, the positive 155 will come across, make a negative 155. So negative 157 is equal to 32x. X is equal to negative 157 over what? Suggestion is don't let these get cold. You need to go home and do some extra ones. Do some on the homework. Do some in the book. Do some whatever. Out of six, whatever chapter this is, 6.2. So you need to make sure you don't let it get cold when you go home or between now and Wednesday. You don't need to let it get cold. Now, 6.3 is not a very bad section because you're not going to have a lot of it on the test. You may have a couple of questions on the test. Y'all just came out of 80% of the test. 6.2 is going to be 80% of your test.
Wait, 6.1.
6.2. 6.1 is not. 6.2 is.
Oh, it was 6.2.
Yeah, 6.2 is going to be 70% of your test. 6.3, you might have two questions. There's two types of questions in 6.3. 6.3 is called formulas. And we're going to talk about what the two types of questions are with formulas. Okay, 6.2 formulas. There's two types of questions. One is plug and chug. Just like we did in 6.1. Okay, in other words, they give you a formula and they tell you what parts of the formula, that they give you some numbers for it, and you just plug and chug and do your order of operations. They're real simple. Let me give you an example. Perimeter is equal to 2L plus 2W. And L is equal to 4, and W is equal to 1. No, 4. Okay, give you 4. Not 4 for both. Let me do... because that'll confuse people. Let's do W is equal to 7. All right, so plug and chug. P is equal to 2 parentheses plus 2 parentheses. And 4 will go here, and W will go here. And that'll give us 8 plus 14, which is what? 22. And that's how you do the first type of formula question. Not very difficult, and most of you have done this, especially if you've taken some type of science or math. Usually they give you a formula, they give you what to plug in, and then you do it. Pretty self-explanatory. Don't spend a lot of time on those. What I do spend a lot of time on is the second type problem. The second type problem is to solve for a variable. In other words, can't spell. In other words, you got to use a little bit of algebra. Now, let's take that same problem, P is equal to 2L plus 2W. And then I say, solve for W. Just algebra. All that stuff that you just learned, you're going to use here. So, first of all, the first thing you do is make sure you don't have any fractions. Make sure that you don't have any fractions in your formula. Because if you do, you need to clear them first by multiplying through by the common denominator, which we just finished doing. Yeah. All right? Now, once you've cleared the fractions, then B, use algebra to get
the variable what?
By itself.
By itself. Now in this problem, we don't have a fraction. 2L plus 2W. So everything's good. We want to get W by itself. So I'm going to move everything over. And I'm going to go over here and we're going to keep on going. So P is equal to 2L plus 2W. I want to get W by itself. So I want to leave it alone for right now. So I got to get that 2L across the river. And what's in front of that 2L? A plus. If I take it across the river, which is this, the equal sign is the river. If I take it across the river, what does it become?
You have to subtract negative.
A negative or a subtraction of 2L. So P minus 2L is equal to 2W. I took this across the river and it became a minus 2L. Now what? How do you undo multiplying by 2?
You would divide.
So I divide here by 2. And if I do it here, I got to do it here. So my final answer is W is equal to P minus 2L over 2. These are the ones that give people problems out of the two problems. The first one, y'all do those all day long. Y'all plug and chug and everybody's happy. When I give you one of these, y'all skip it and go to the next problem. So let's do some of these.
I have a question.
Yeah.
It might be this. I don't know. I was doing the homework for this chapter and I had this statistics formula.
Yeah.
And I hate it. Like, with a passion, I hate it. But they gave me all the numbers. Mm-hmm. And I plugged it in, and I did it. And I did it myself. Then I did it on a calculator. Then I did it in the freaking computer on a calculator. And every answer I came up with was wrong. So how do you freaking do it? All right.
Well, let's do it.
I hate that formula. It's evil.
It is a conspiracy.
It is a conspiracy. Why do you have to use every alpha number?
I did not do it. I did not make up that formula.
I understand
that. It was made a long time ago.
But I don't understand why they got to use every letter in the alphabet to just irritate the crap out of us.
It is. The memo went out about 100,000 years ago, and it says this formula was configured so that we could piss students off.
It wouldn't surprise me.
And it was written by Euphrates.
Basically, yeah. They got bored and had nothing better.
That's
to do
what they
than
did. They said, let's see how we can really piss students off.
It's horrible. I hate that formula.
I just can't believe y'all just didn't get the memo. There
it's the right statistics there. Formula. It's horrible.
Number 22,
it's
right
got
there.
T's and N's and mu's and I don't even know what that is.
Well, I'm glad you know what mu is.
Well, that's because I remember from last semester, but I still don't know what it is.
Well,
it's
good
letter.
That you know
that's
that.
All I freaking know. It's
all right, number 22.
Pretty much.
Now, place. What did I tell you the word determined meant?
I think three classes ago.
Determined means plug in what?
Okay, but I did that, and I still came up with the wrong answer. I don't understand.
I'm letting everybody copy it down. Thank you.
no idea. I haven't found it yet, but I'll see if we do it. Let's see, 66 minus 60 over 15 over the square root of n, and the square root of n, so that'd be 15 over 5, which would be 3. So it'd be 6 over 3, which is 2.
That was hard?
Yeah. To some people it is. All right.
Well, I'm just stupid. So
no, you're not. All right. Now, let's go ahead and do it. Let's go. And I'll tell you where a lot of people, like you said, you have a problem because there's so much stuff right here that you just get overwhelmed. First of all, the x bar, that's an average. That's a number. It's an average.
That's the z-score
formula,
right?
No, exactly. Good. Z-score formula. This mu is the population average. This is the sample average. So these are just two numbers that's used. All right? 66. So this would be like, if I wanted to find the average test score at Tri-County Tech, and I used the Anderson campus as a sample for all the campuses. This would be the average at Anderson campus. This would be the average at Tri-County Tech, being the whole, all campuses. And this is my standard deviation. That's what that is. That's called sigma. Is 15, and then n is how many people I've actually got the test scores from. And that's what those numbers are. They're just numbers. So you take x bar, I'm sorry, and y'all just get mad, but I'm just going to write on here because I don't feel like copying all that over. All right, so z is equal to x bar minus mu over sigma over the square root of n. And now I'm going to, there we go, and I'll take it to a whiteboard and plug in the numbers. Y'all make sure y'all write the numbers down. Control C, and that way everybody can see it. Control V, there we go. Now, the x bar is 66, so that'd be 66 minus 60 over
15
over the square root of 25. Well, the square root of 25 is 5. Now, notice I put this in parentheses because this whole thing right here is the denominator. So we need to go ahead and do this to get a single digit or a single number, single term as a denominator, because right now we got two terms.
So we have to do that first?
I would, yes. Okay. So that'd be 66 minus 60 over 3. Now you have a fraction, so just go ahead and do it. 66 minus 60 is what? 6, and 6 over 3 is 2. And that's probably one of the answers that you got.
No, it wasn't, because I tried every answer that I had gone.
Y'all, you were probably,
they all kept coming up wrong.
Probably what you were doing is doing a different order of operations each time.
Probably.
And what you need to think about doing.
I never did the bottom first.
I know. You got this, that's subtraction, division, and division. You got brother, you got cousins. So please excuse my dear Aunt Sally, and if you go down, which that's what you do with math, and that's what we're doing, division comes first. So you need to do this division first. Now, why do you do this one first? Because you can't do division by division. You can't do that. So you have to pick one of them. Well, you can actually divide this 3 right here, by this. You get the same thing, 3 over 15 over 5
So we went ahead and we did this right here. Now we're going to divide this by this. What do you do when you divide something by a fraction? What do? You multiply by the what?
Reciprocal.
And this is 5 over 15. And then this will cancel. 3 will go in that. And basically you're going to get, you should get the same answer. So, but I'm not going to do it that way because it all gets all messed up. So I'm not going to do it that way. But you don't, you, what you do is you do this one first because it's in parentheses. I didn't put it in parentheses. But you want to get this denominator. What I'm trying to show you is this is the big fraction bar right here. Uh-huh. You want to get this as a single number.
Okay.
That's the best thing I can tell you to do.
Okay.
And that'll give you 2. All right, we're going to end with that one because I got to get the roll and y'all got to get out of here. Because some of y'all are doing pretty at my fortune if I go more than. Let's see. Here we go. Course listing, this is math 155. Oh, let me go ahead and stop this. And let me stop this too. Now I've covered 6.1 through what? 6.3. So y'all should be working.